As the flood levels drop, city businesses along the river are beginning to emerge from the muddy water. Most of Gardens Point is closed, while at Kangaroo Point, the jazz club is swinging into clean-up mode.
In its 50-year history, the jazz club at Kangaroo Point has flooded three times. They can't get insurance, and on Saturday watched the river rage.
So a little yacht come down and hit the ferry terminal that the weather walkway is, and it got swallowed up, and we were in fear of the club.
Inspecting the damage today.
Yeah, 2011 floods were the worst. They're up to about there. This one's down here.
The grand piano was spared, but the damage bill is estimated at up to $30,000.
Our insurance is the people that love this club. 2,000 members, a lot of volunteers.
Following days of tidal ebbs and flows, finally river levels are starting to recede, but for many it's just providing the first glimpse of the extraordinary damage this flooding event has caused. Pontoons continue to float down the river, this one washing up on the Sunshine Coast.
And we seem to have a visitor from Brisbane.
At Gardens Point, a brand new bar and bikeways are now fenced off.
I don't think I've seen anything like this before.
Floating pontoons and, yeah, things still, like, the tide's still really high.
QUT's campus is closed and being cleaned. Surrounding roads are slick with mud. Car parks underwater, being pumped out at Eagle Street. Dropping water levels slowly reveal more of the businesses that lie beneath. Ben Murphy, 7 News.